I appreciate you sharing your story with me, so I figured I'd share mine with you. I got in last night from Austin, Texas, where I had spent the last 2.5 weeks training with the great John Danaher, really an incredible mind in Jiu Jitsu. Looking forward to sharing that with you in the next episode of Diary of a Black Belt. But for this episode, I wanted to share a story of when I came home, I received a gift. There's something about people sharing their stories with you as an instructor. They want to share their training history. They want to share their heart. And so I came home to a gift. I wasn't expecting a package. And I thought, Louisiana? I'm not expecting anything from Louisiana. But I got a package of perhaps the greatest gift of all for men. The gift of jerky. The gift of meat. Let's see if we can get that in there. Yeah. So this is Bourgeois Meat Market Cajun Beef Jerky. And this is very special jerky. This is not just, you can't just get this at the store. This is special stuff. And it came with a letter, and I want to share that letter with you. So here we go. Professor Dean, I recently finished your book, Becoming the Black Belt, for the second time last week while on a hunting trip. I was camping in a national forest out the back of my truck for 4 days. I was alone for the first 2 days while waiting for my buddies to arrive. I listened to the first third of the book in the truck on the way up, and the next third with my phone resting on my tailgate in a stainless steel coffee cup to amplify while setting up my tarps, messing with my gear, cooking, and while sitting by the fire. The last third was listened to through one earbud on the lowest possible volume while 25 feet up in a tree, hanging from a hunting saddle with a bow in my hand and a smile on my face. It was the right book at the right time for me. It helped me organize some thoughts and solidified some of my beliefs as a martial artist. I've been digging deep into the title of martial artist and what that means to me, finding ways to apply it to business, parenting, marriage, teaching, and learning. Because of my lineage and the fortunate training opportunities I've had, the story about you competing against Dan Camarillo had me pacing around the campfire for quite some time. Well done. Though I was rooting for the underdog, part of me wanted Dan to give you some air miles. And he definitely could, still can. I manage an old school butcher shop in Thibodaux, Louisiana, that was started by my great-grandfather in 1891. My cousins and I have expanded the fourth generation business by opening our second location earlier this year. We are a full-service butcher shop, but we are known globally for our beef jerky, which I will circle back to later. Most importantly, our business and family are filled with dangerous people, and we all train together at Next Generation Martial Arts in Thibodaux, Louisiana. This is a guerrilla jiu-jitsu affiliate. Guerrilla Jiu-Jitsu was founded by Dave Camarillo. Incredibly technical. I've long admired him and his brother. Here is our current family tree of jiu-jitsu practitioners. And he lists a family, wife, cousins, employees. Quite extensive, very impressive. Our lineage, Dave Camarillo, to Ernest Waffle Ellender, to Scotty Smith. Page 2. Isn't this a beautiful letter? Maybe in a few years, once Brody and I catch up to Bo, we can market ourselves as the most dangerous butcher shop on the planet. Or perhaps you'll hear about the Black Belt Butchers podcast at some point. Ha ha. Anything's possible. And it is. You're making it happen right now by putting it into print. Anyways, I enjoyed the book and I'm hoping the YouTube content keeps coming. I love the crucibles, demos, and narrations. Really nothing else like it out there. 360 camera work, empty mats, no music. You can hear the guys breathing the way it should be. Our jerky has no nitrates, sugars, or preservatives like the rest. We use whole muscle strips, hung by hand, one piece at a time, onto rails, and smoked all day long in smokehouses designed by our great-grandfather. This smoking process is an art. In jiu-jitsu, the training partner has a say. They are a variable. Same with smoking. Nature is the variable, and it absolutely has a say. Every day is different. Every piece of wood is different. Humidity, wind, temperature, it all matters. Everything matters. There are quicker, more efficient ways to make it, but they don't taste the same if they're done like that. Sadly, any jerky you've seen in the store has gone that route. The smart for business route. We will never do that. We always do it the hard way, and we will teach our kids the same way, the right way. If you're ever in search of gifts for family members or training partners, please keep us in mind. We ship this stuff all over the country on a daily basis. Enjoy. I appreciate you sharing your story with me, so I figured I'd share mine with you. Signed, Shane Thibodeau, Bourgeois Meat Market, and his contact information, which I will leave in the comments below. That's all I got. If you like this kind of content, like, subscribe, leave a comment below, and get ready for the next episode. It's going to be fantastic. Okay, we'll see you in the next video. Thank you.